Gushik and Wright floors Tito Abella in October 1979. Photo courtesy of Shirai Gushik and Jim Yoko. Gushik was a mainstay in the junior flyweight division in the late 1970s, early 80s. All told, he reigned for 4 years and 5 months and successfully defended his WBA title on 13 occasions. At the time, both were division records. Gushik was born in Ishigaki, a small city in the southwest of Japan, on the island of Okinawa, on June 26, 1955. His parents had 4 children. Growing up in such exotic surroundings helped mold him in his early years. "My family was not rich," Gushik told RingTV.com through Tomoyuki Kadaoka. "I loved athletics and ran around the fields. I loved diving into the sea in order to get fish and shellfish." Gushik was first introduced to boxing by a friend whilst in high school. He won an inter-high school championship in 1973 before leaving the unpaid ranks with a record of 623. At the age of 18 years old, Gushik debuted in May 1974 and progressed quickly. He won 8 fights inside 2.5 years before his team were able to lure WBA flyweight title holder Juan Antonio Guzman to Japan. "I was able to get self-confidence through winning my 7th fight Cesar Gomez KA by KO," said Gushik of his quick progression. "I had always trained hard to obtain stamina and strong mind." Gushik, known as Kanmuri Washi Fierce Eagle, knocked out Guzman in the 7th round to begin his reign. Not surprisingly, he considers that to be his proudest moment in boxing. During the first half of 1977, Gushik edged talented former title holder Jaime Rios and Rigoberto Marcano, both via 15-round split decision. However, the Japanese star stopped both men in rematches. He would establish himself as the premier 108-pounder in the world over the next 2 years, defeating former, future and world champions and perennial contenders Alfonso López KO 7, Rafael Pedroza UD 15, Martin Vargas KO 8 and Pedro Flores UD 15. Gushik lost his unbeaten record and title to Flores in their March 1981 rematch. Surprisingly, at just 25 years old, he decided to retire for several reasons. "I had a severe damage in my eye," he explained. "But more than that, I had a feeling of satisfaction that I had done everything in boxing." Although he made 13 titles defenses, Gushik had hoped to make more. "I should have been able to achieve, at the least, 15 consecutive defenses," he said. To his credit, Gushik never returned, exiting the sport with a record of 231, 15 knockouts. In 1995, he opened the Shirai Gushik Gym in Tokyo with the first Japanese-born world champion, Yoshio Shirai. After Shirai's death in 2003, Gushik managed it. The gym spawned its first world champion earlier this year, when Daigo Higa won the WBC flyweight title. Higa, who is rated number 3 by the ring at 112 pounds, will make his first defense against Thomas Masson on Sunday in Kokujikan. "I am very happy to have met Higa," said Gushik of his prized pupil. "He is mentally and physically very strong. The strongest I have met. I think it would be difficult to find such a strong boxer as Higa. I am looking forward to having Higa grow more and more." Gushik Wright with Daigo Higa. Photo courtesy of Shirai Gushik Gym. Despite his relatively short career, Gushik achieved a lot and received due recognition in 2015 when he was inducted into the International Boxing Hall of Fame. Gushik, now 62, lives in Tokyo. He is married and has 2 children. The former champion regularly appears on TV as a variety show entertainer for Cream Quiz Miracle 9, which airs on TV Asahi. He has also appeared in several other shows and commentates on boxing for Fuji. He graciously took time to speak to RingTV.com about the best he fought in 10 key categories. Best jabs: Jaime Rios. His jabs had high of speed. He had a good sense of rhythm. He could land good jabs against me. It was difficult for me to counter him properly. Best defense: Rigoberto Marcano. I could not find any weakness in him in our first fight. During every round, he would keep his guard up. He kept a wonderful style of defense during the bout. Fastest hands: Rios. His punches were not only fast but also had some unique angles. Therefore, I could not forecast from where his punches would come. Best footwork: Rios. He had a unique sense of rhythm. He had his great flexibility in his lower body and also upper body and made unpredictable moves during the bout. I think many boxers from Panama have had this kind of flexibility. Best chin: Rafael Pedroza. His chin was steady and his body was hard and strong, and therefore my punches did not have any effect to him. Smartest Marcano. His opponent could not land any punches on him. His body had great core strength and therefore his moves were well balanced without wasted motion. Strongest Juan Antonio Guzman. He had a strong body and also powerful punches. Best puncher Alfonso Lopez. He hurt me. He was an ex-world champion in flyweight class and therefore his body was slightly larger than mine. My damage was bigger than ever. He was able to land good body blows and effective combination punches. Boxing skills Pedro Flores. I could not get close to him by landing jabs and straight punches because he had good skills to make me fail. Best overall Rios. He had wonderful speed, footwork and speed of punches. Tomoyuki Kitaoka helped coordinate and translate this feature. RingTV.com appreciates his assistance. Questions and or comments can be sent to Anson at email protected and you can follow him at www.twitter.com. Anson Wainwright. Struggling to locate a copy of the Ring magazine? Try here or subscribe. You can order the current issue, which is on newsstands, or back issues from our subscribe page. On the cover this month, Mikey Garcia.